हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ प्रोफेसर ए के शेख वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एंड हेड ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एट एन बी नवले सिंहगढ़ कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग सोलापुर। आई हैव कम्प्लीटेड माई एम ई मैकेनिकल इन डिज़ाइन इंजीनियरिंग एंड आई हैव 12 ईयर्स ऑफ टीचिंग एक्सपीरियंस। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू सी बैलेंसिंग ऑफ सेवरल मासेस रोटेटिंग इन सेम प्लेन बाई ग्राफिकल मेथड। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी आर डिस्कस्ड बैलेंसिंग ऑफ सेवरल मासेस rotating in the same plane by analytical method. So let us now go to graphical method. So this was the system under consideration, M1, M2, M3 and M4, where the masses rotating in the same plane. The plane of rotation is the screen itself and the axis of rotation is perpendicular to the screen and passing through point O. R1, R2, R3 and R4 are the radii of rotation for the masses correspondingly. Theta1, Theta2, Theta3 and Theta4 are the inclinations of the masses with reference line OX measured in the same line. And FC1, FC2, FC3 and FC4 are the centrifugal forces. Here the magnitude of the centrifugal forces is considered as product of mass and radius, because omega is common to all the masses, hence it is kept aside for the sake of simplification. So FC1 will be M1R1, FC2 will be equal to M2R2, FC3 will be equal to M3R3 and FC4 will be equal to M4R4. So let us now go through the graphical method to find the balancing force. So let us revise our basics before we go to the actual graphical method. So basics of finding resultant of multiple vectors by graphical method. So we have seen in the analytical method that when there were multiple forces, we had gone for resolving that multiple forces into horizontal and vertical components, and then we have gone for summation of horizontal components, then summation of vertical components, and then calculating the resultant by Pythagoras theorem, and then finding the angle by tan theta, that is using trigonometry. Analytical method can be suitable for a system with small number of forces or small number of masses, but when the quantity of masses is large, when the system is complicated, so the analytical method, which involves resolution of forces in the different directions and then again analyzing the components, so it becomes little bit difficult in cases where there are multiple masses, because there will be multiple forces and hence multiple components. So to overcome this limitation of the analytical method, we come across this graphical method, which gives us an advantage of simplification irrespective of the number of quantities involved in the analysis. So in the graphical method, let us analyze how to find out the resultant. Suppose this is the vector number 1 as represented, then we have the vector number 2 continuous order, then vector number 3, then vector number 4. Suppose there are 4 vectors, 1, 2, 3, 4, and we need to find out the resultant of these vectors. So in case of vectors, if we join the first point of first vector to the last point of the last vector, so our first vector is vector number 1, the first point is here, last vector is vector number 4, and the last point of that vector is here. So if we join this first point to the last point, first point of first vector to the last point of the last vector, we get the resultant. This is the advantage of the graphical method. So instead of 4, if there are 7, 8, 9, 10 vectors, even then there will not be any problem. We need to plot the vectors in sequence to the proper scale, and then join the first point of the first vector to the last point of the last vector to get the resultant. So now let us apply this method to our case. So in our case, first we need to draw the space diagram. Next, calculate the centrifugal forces. As discussed earlier, the centrifugal forces are Fc1 equal to m1 r1, Fc2 equal to m2 r2, Fc3 equal to m3 r3, and Fc4 equal to m4 r4. Now we have to choose a proper scale which is suitable to the magnitude of the obtained forces, and then we can go for drawing the vectors. So we can draw a vector which will represent Fc1, that is m1 r1 in magnitude, and direction will be parallel to this radius r1. Similarly, there will be a vector which will represent Fc2, magnitude m2 r2, and the direction parallel to this r2, and hence for Fc3 and Fc4. So let us start with the vector diagram. So the first vector, we are starting with point A. So this vector is now representing m1 r1, that is Fc1. It is parallel to direction of Fc1, that is parallel to this radius r1, and magnitude corresponding to m1 r1. Next, parallel to Fc2, corresponding to m2 r2 in magnitude, and direction parallel to r2, that is our Fc2. Then we have Fc3 parallel to Fc3, vector CD, and corresponding to magnitude m3 r3. Then we have vector DE corresponding to magnitude m4 r4 of Fc4, and the direction parallel to Fc4 or parallel to radius r4. Now these are our four active forces, and now we need to find out the resultant. And as we discussed, the resultant is the vector joining the first point of the first vector to the last point of the last vector. So this is our resultant. Vector AE shall be the resultant of this force system. So as per the polygon law of forces, the closing side AE represents the resultant force in magnitude and direction, this force. So as we obtained this by the force polygon, the closing side is resultant. So this Fc is the resultant of all these forces, and it will be represented here. And now as per our methodology, the balancing force is equal to the resultant force, but it is opposite in the direction. So the first step is to find out the resultant acting force so as to apply the balance force opposite to this resultant. So the balancing force will be opposite to this resultant Fc. So the graphical method helps us to find out the magnitude of the resultant force and the inclination of the resultant force. And once we get the magnitude and inclination of this resultant force, it is simple to get the magnitude and inclination of this balancing force. And once we get the balancing force, we can equate that to product of mass into radius to find out the balancing mass and radius of rotation for the balancing mass. MR, we have to equate it to resultant of this Fc1, Fc2, Fc3, Fc4. That is finally we say as Fc.